get those done and to knock out very soon. The upcoming Virginia General Assembly, the Federal Reserve protest on January 16th, and the later one, which is Occupy the Fed later on in the year. I don't have specifics on that personally. Reoccupation/satellite occupations, also a bit later in the year. It is an election year, 2012. This is a sense of urgency and haste to literally everything we do, and always keep it in mind when we're talking, please. And the listening campaign, which was, can you jump in on that? I forgot what it was again.
Yeah, it was a bunch of different things. Simply the idea that we're not here to go out in the community and tell them what to think and tell them what's wrong with the 99%. We're out there to go to try to gather their ideas and their issues and listen to what they have to say.
Okay, so again, we're going to break out into groups the first time. We're going to stick with these three conceptual groups, so three groups, or was it? Yeah. So whichever one that you feel is the most important or have the skill set to gravitate towards, just go to that. I would say like communication here, or communication in the middle, education over here, outreach over here. And then we're going to do come back, sort of discuss/announce things in general, and then we are going to break out again for the more specific events, and there will be more groups that are created for that. But real quick, before we do that, we have, I'm going to go around some introductions for people, because we have a lot of new faces again. Yay. Very yay.
Yeah, very yay.
And we want to do some quick work group announcements, because we haven't had a big meeting for a while. So, I guess I'll start with you.
Why are we breaking up into communication, education, and outreach? Can you clarify that just a little bit?
Those are the three things that people seem to have the most concern over
and
the last strategy meeting and just working on them.
Mm-hmm.
So generate new ideas and things like that and keep the 2012 thing in mind for that. So I guess I'll go first with introductions and then we'll kind of go start Isaac after me and sort of wind back and forth. Don't worry about it. It'll be organic. People get confused, but don't be a big deal. I'm Jonathan. I'm with Auxiliary. Been here since the first meeting. I'm here for a whole host of reasons, but I really feel like I have to be here as important as possible. I don't want to, but I have to work. Isaac, you want to?
Hey, what's up? I'm Isaac. I'm taking notes on this meeting. Scribing. I'm really interested in helping with the facilitation work group in 2012 to strengthen our general assemblies and how we communicate with each other.
My name is Ron. I'm with communication, COCO, to try and make all these meetings run smoother, more smoothly.
I'm Josh. I'm working with the COC, Committee of Correspondence, trying to talk with other occupiers and other stuff.
Say hi.
Hey everyone, I'm Jan. I'm on the legal team and on the action committee. It's good to be here.
I'm Dave. I'm from Chester County. I'm here for a different reason, but help with communication.
Anyway. I'm Sarah. I'm here for a lot of reasons. There are a lot of cameras on me right now. but I think we need to really work on communication because that's been a big problem in the past. So let's fix it.
I'm Tyler. I'm here really as an observer with a friend.
Hey, I'm Josh. I've been with Occupy since the first meeting. Here because I think that this thing is way bigger than any one of us. So it's important that we all like use our bodies and our minds to propel justice forward, because we live in a really unjust society, like San Bueno, in a country that claims to be more legitimate. And I'm here to focus, at this point, a lot on the education side of Occupy. I think that there's a lot of value in educating the public with like stats and facts instead of just bias, and I want to see how I can help make that process easier.
I'm Alex. I've been here since essentially the second meeting, I guess. I've been working with media primarily, and also partly with action, and that's about it.
I'm Sir. I'm just pleased to be here. Been with Occupy since we occupied
at Kanawha the 15th. I'm just really here to listen this evening, just to listen, hopefully.
I'm Dana, and I've sort of come in and out of the Occupy thing since the second main meeting, and I'm just here to sort of figure out where I can play.
My name's Jim. I'm just here to listen and to see where I can offer support.
Oh. Hi, my name's Reed. I've been here since we took Kanawha, and I just sort of help out wherever I feel like I can. Kind of do that.
I'm Rich, I'm just Ditto Reed, and since I've been gone for the holidays, I'm trying to get back into the groove.
Hi, I'm Layla. I've been involved, I guess, since the beginning of Occupation. I'm just going to be around a lot.
I'm Lynn Marie. This is my second meeting. I just moved back to Richmond from Chicago via Pittsburgh. I'm here to see kind of where I fit in. I'm more interested in local currency, gift economy, and food security. Those are like my major issues.
I'm Reed, and you should probably figure this out now. But I'm visiting from Missoula, Montana, and here to offer support.
Yeah, Missoula.
Yeah.
I'm Alan. I've been here since before Kanawha, and I'm here. I like it.
I'm Phil. I've just seen what you guys have done out in the community, and I like it, so just here to listen.
I'm Terrell, just here to learn.
I'm Vaughn, and I'm here to help.
I'm Whitney, and I'm just glad to be here after all the holiday stuff. I don't have any other constructive thoughts on that. It's really good to see all your beautiful faces.
Okay, I'm Nicole, and I've been involved since before Kanawha. I'm kind of in a lot of areas, mainly arts and crafts. But yeah, just wanna be here and involved.
Hi, I'm Harry. I'm most notably known for jaywalking at Kanawha. I gained obstruction of justice for that. And yeah, I'm here to figure out how best I can help.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully that'll be either education or outreach. Yeah.
My name's Carter, and I don't really feel safe out in the world. I like you people, and I think we can change the world until I do feel safe. It's about the best thing I've seen going on. I love this. It's very inspiring. And Happy New Year.
Thank you, Carter. And we do love you.
My name's Ryan, and I haven't been here in a while, so I'm just trying to get caught up to that.
Silent.
Obviously.
That's it?
Yeah.
Wow. That's really self-deprecating.
I'm Graham, and I tend to insert myself where I think I'm necessary, which doesn't always, it's not always true. And I should be involved with the work group.
I'm Claire, and right now I'm involved with Action, but I've changed a lot. I've been here before Occupation started, and I was with Auxiliary, and I moved from work group to work group where I saw fit in my second gram. I'm not always right on that, but I'm happy to keep learning.
I'm Chris. I'm up from Wilmington, North Carolina, and I fell in love with a group of people down at Kanawha Plaza. And pretty much I try to work with the facilitation work group and a lot of outreach and education. And then the kitchen, where I'm actually about to go now. I didn't know it was going to be as many of you, but I'm going to try to throw some good snacks.
Okay, I'm Greg. I just love what we've done. I was especially inspired when I came to Kanawha, and I would like to make this thing sustainable.
Hey everybody, my name is Rishi. This is my first time at Occupy Richmond anything, so great to be here.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you. I'm an organizer and the new communications guy with the group called Virginia New Majority. So I'm here to hear about all the work that y'all are doing and tell y'all about an action happening next Tuesday, if possible.
Hi, my name is Muna, and I've been working with Occupy Richmond off and on for a while. Long-time activist here in Virginia, and I'm organizing with SEIU, and I do a lot of inviting folks like Rishi down to meetings like this and telling big progressive groups how great you all are.
Hi, I'm Alan. I've been around here. I'm kind of at the place right now where I'm curious and wanting to be caught up to date with where things are, where things are heading, and kind of trying to figure out what are the spaces that require really me, that I have something unique to give, to balance that kind of exceptional responding to something that is unique as opposed to just putting in the hours. Not that I have a limited amount of time, so it seems to me if there's large numbers of people who can easily do something, I really should kind of look around and poke and prod and pick your brains on, as time goes on, find out what's the most potent way I can contribute. So that's what I'm looking for.
My name is Greg, and I've been kind of in and out of the Occupy movement since more or less the beginning. One of my interests is wondering how we, the Occupy movement, could use 9/11, the crimes of 9/11, as a stone to bring down the Goliath of the structure that we're raging against. From my point of view, without recognizing or without embracing this terrible truth that occurred on 9/11/01, without confronting that in a serious sort of manner, this movement doesn't have much hope of really success, any success. I get kind of emotional around big groups and volatile kind of things. So anyway, I really think it's important that we somehow confront this, and I really don't know how this is going to be done, because it's a huge monster. You know, it's the elephant rhinoceros head on the boardroom table that kind of nobody wants to look at or confront. And yet, it shows us clearly, just by examining what happened, that this system is fucked. And that there's no way we can put band-aids on it and kind of work within the system to change it, okay? So our effort has to be a long-term effort into the future, not today, tomorrow, next year. We have to make plans for how we are going to survive, I think, especially in the face of the bill that just passed and the president just blew through. It's the final culmination of 9/11/01, the crimes of 9/11/01. It's what, you know, have seen a 10-year period now. Patriot Act, this, and this. And finally, we've been designated enemies if our government or the president chooses to do that. So we're backed up against the wall, basically. And this is not going to be an easy fix.
Thank you, Greg.
I'm Jeremy. I've been involved since
early October, mostly with media, but I'm looking to get involved with facilitation. I think honing our collective decision-making process is one of the most powerful things we can do in this interim, so that we can get involved in 2012 when things warm up in a really effective way.
I'm Dudley, and I think I've been here since the day I was born. I think I was born to Occupy. This movement is really important to me. I'm in education and outreach. I'm here to serve and listen. And I really think that the decisions that we make in 2012 were really important. We've got so much going on right now. We're moving so fast, it's really hard to keep up. But I'd like to keep up and bring some positive energy into this world.
Hi, I'm Ron Skinner. I'm a long-time researcher. I've only been in Occupy here for 6 weeks. Like many other people you read about in the press, I think it's the tip of the unformed iceberg that can't be resisted because it's the majority of the world, and yet because we don't have a focused point, and we haven't really made the dent, we will, and look forward to us making a lot of dents and a lot of corrupt institutions so we can have the resources and the people who really would like to be sharing them in charge instead of the very, very clever legalistic people who have manipulated their way into, connived their way into running the scene. Sorry, Mr. Lloyd.
I'm Chris, and I'm from Newport News, and I've been involved in the Occupy movement generally since actually about August. So my main reasons for being here are because I'm interested in saving my country from the from what appears to be a corporatist and totalitarian leaning, and by extension of saving the country, possibly save the world. So that's my reason.
My name is Dee, and I'm here representing seniors. I don't see many of them here, but and I have been spreading the word and trying, you know, my friends, we're all retired and comfortable enough, which is a good thing. But I'm trying to get them to get their heads out of the sand and think about the future. And my major reason for being here, I guess, and attending events is for my 9 grandkids. Christopher's one of them, because I'm really worried about their future.
Hey everyone, I'm Vanessa. I've been involved in Occupy for a while now as well, and I have been away for a bit, so I'm trying to get back in the groove.
Okay, is that everybody?
I like that too. we're going to spend some minutes on a meeting, going to do some real quick work group announcements, and then break out into groups. So, other than nobody else will be doing this, I don't actually have any work group announcements. I don't know if anyone else does.
Agenda, but we did go over some of the things the strategy went, like the list that strategy came up with last week, and you know, we just had some ideas on that, and actually a which some of it I'll talk about in the smaller groups we break up into, but a Federal Reserve Task Force has now been formed already, and Ron and Isaac are both point people for that. We are putting out a call for a task force to be formed for the May 1st strike as well, national strike. So we need a task force for that as well. Maybe we can talk about that in the next direct action meeting for those that are interested to come talk to us about it. We also have a taking space meeting planned for Sunday, the 22nd of January at 7 p.m. That was going to be at Helen's until Mark Holmberg tried to show up there tonight for this meeting, so that might not be the best idea. But we'll figure it out. We'll post it. Just know that there is going to be a meeting about what taking a space means, the ideas around that, the ideas that everyone has, the many ways you can do that, the many reasons why, and all that stuff, and get that conversation going. And I think the reason was to maybe try and take a space. For several reasons, doesn't mean we can't afford that or can't have that or whatever reason, but try for around March on a number of different levels. So those two things came out of that. And then I also had a meeting with a really good friend of mine today. I work for a group called Alliance for Progressive Values, and he is the public policy director and is going to be doing a lot of lobbying in the General Assembly this year. So I just wanted to chat with him. I did some lobbying internships with him and just chat with him about the GA and what he thought about for Occupy and that kind of stuff. So I have some information from him, and Will actually sat with us. So we have some ideas and information about what the General Assembly for Occupy could look like. So that's it. Those are both sort of action announcements.
Does anybody else have any?
Isaac.
Yeah, facilitation, work group, and communications met on December 26th to discuss ways of improving our General Assemblies. We discussed process issues, structural issues, how we work with each other. And we are meeting tomorrow at 6 p.m. in Oregon Hill, 325 South Cherry Street. If you're interested in coming, please come on time. We only have till about 8 o'clock. And we will be looking at the notes from the last meeting. Definitely open to hearing more critiques for our General Assembly and fresh points. But we're very interested in forming a serious facilitation work group, I think, and finding people. So if you're interested in working with facilitation, please come tomorrow. If you can, you can talk to me. And also, if you have issues with GA and feel like there's some issues that you'd like to share with us, please come.
Repeat that time, please.
6 to 8 p.m. tomorrow in Oregon Hill, 325 South Cherry Street. It's an American flag on the door.
Hey, what's up, y'all? I'm Josh. I'm recording on behalf of the media group. Got a couple of initiatives that we're throwing together now. We all know that we've had some communications difficulties over the last 3 months. So a couple things that we're doing to work on that. Number one, we're putting together another internet site for us to utilize called rvaga.org. That will essentially be a hub for everything GA, where we can get proposals submitted beforehand, and we can have like an agenda when we work with our facilitation crew that will be prepared before the meeting. With all of our like points of process and hand signals and everything consolidated into one easy-to-use site, but I think we're going to have social media included in it, right? It's going to be like sort of like a Facebook.
It's going to be our own social network.
Yeah, so that'll be pretty cool. We're also getting an email, like a digest put out once or twice a week. We're getting that put together, so hopefully any communications issues we're having where we can't access Facebook or we can't access the OccuPhone or whatever, you know, we'll be sending out updates once or twice a week about everything going on. And on that topic, we're trying to work with them to get a blog post about every meeting so we can have a summary of what's done at every single meeting put on the website for everyone to see, which will be really awesome. What else am I missing from media? What else are we doing right now? Jeremy, Will, anything?
Our media meeting is on Thursday.
And we have a media meeting on Thursday at 7 p.m. We'd love anyone to come who has suggestions for how we can vamp up our own communications or our media resources. It's going to be at, have we decided yet?
We have not.
We'll get that information out on Facebook.
Education outreach. I put together very quickly, and I apologize, a timeline and some lists of things to do that we will, when we break up into small groups, I'll give each group a handout. Basically, I would love if every working group could add to the timeline from past to present to future. There's also a space for upcoming work group meeting times for the next week or so, so that everybody can get involved in that. Also, just a list of things to review. We don't necessarily have to discuss tonight, but they're just things that were coming up very frequently. And any proposal ideas that anyone has can also put on a list here on the handout that I have, so that for the GA next week, we can kind of be a couple of steps ahead of the game. And I have a really long list for things that we need for Occupy the Hood this weekend. I'll just go over it really quickly so everybody can hear it. We need a small PA, and a generator, a projector, a sheet for the projector, flyer runners. We've got thousands of flyers here today. We need food, water, drinks, donation box, printed materials to hand out at the event, Occupy the Hood stickers and a mission statement, porta potty, because there's no restroom there. We're going to be there all day. And just in case of bad weather, we need to be prepared for that. We've got radio and text promotions coming up, and we need a storage run with inventory, Know Your Rights training and Cop Watch, target enforcement zone research, and other little materials that we need. And if anybody can add to the list of things to do for Saturday that we have not thought of, that would be great. Also, there's another list of things to do for education outreach, and we need everybody's help and opinions. Yes?
What size gym do you need? Like, do you know what wattage?
We don't have access to any electricity there, so I don't know, because I'm not, you know, in the technical logical field, okay. But a generator, I don't know.
I guess it's better than a PA.
Right.
A small PA, it's just PA's for,
okay.
Yeah, noise for the phones and...
Something that could run a refrigerator or two would probably be best, right?
Sure. I don't really know. But if anyone is interested in helping out on any of that, please let me know. We'll be meeting at noon on Friday to get last minute things together, but we'll be working every single day till then.
Okay, last time. Sorry. One last thing, Absurd Action. We'll be having a meeting for the next week or two. If anyone's interested in Absurd Action, either see myself or Jeremy, and we'll get you the details. Just an example of what Absurd Action would be. There was a bunch of activists up in D.C. that held a lemonade stand in a park up in D.C., and they just gave out lemonade. It was either free or for 5 cents or something. What's up?
It works by Capitol Police.
Yeah, and they got arrested by Capitol Police for providing the public with lemonade. So just like absurd actions that would perhaps raise awareness. Yeah.
Okay. I think that's everybody. Yes.
See who went about that? Myself or Jeremy, whenever, tonight.
Okay.
After the
meeting. I think that's everybody. I'd like to say we're going to try to keep this relatively short. Past the 90-minute mark, everyone's attention starts flagging. So 9:30 at the latest. Right before we break into groups, suggestion to me, we do have a lot of new faces or people that haven't had a chance to speak before or whichever, and once we split into threes, I would encourage the new faces, in order to get your ideas put forward, heard by the group on the table in general, please join the outreach group. We want to hear from you. We really, really do. So with that being said, I'd like everybody to please split up into whichever group they feel is most appropriate for them.
Can we split these pews up maybe?
Move the pews or
communication, education.
Yeah, that's what it's about.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So we're doing conceptual stuff first, communication in the middle, please. I guess outreach on the left here, and then education on the right. Yeah, 3 minutes.
Yeah.
Is it interesting in describing?
I'm willing to. You can? I have a digital audio recording. I was thinking more along the lines of describing so that we should bring our notes back.
So I just missed that because I was thinking.
There's going to be a camera.
What's the camera with us?
Sure. I think that there are only a couple of classes, but that's been the output that I think for you, for people to add things to. It's missing anything in the timeline. It's missing anything. That's going to go under flex.
They're all like, they're all the same.
Let's ask Alan. Carter's on. No, it may be gone. Probably, let me look out the window here. They're gone.
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah.
Everyone check down. Check out the new shirt.
Yeah, downstairs, upstairs, whatever suits you. Probably downstairs to the back end.
I thought
outreach is here, education is here, outreach is there. Currently, someone from education is scouting downstairs to see.
It's open.
It's over. This is outreach. This is education.
Outreach is going down there.
No, education.
Education is going down there.
Outreach is over there.
Is everyone here going to be joining in this conversation or what comes? So what is outreach, guys?
What is outreach?
Discussion. Sorry.
Right, you're trying to spread the message, right? So it's,
it's
more than internal communication.
it's kind of one of those things.
Well, we do have a list of things to do, and one of the top priorities on that list is community booklets.
Was anybody talking about the last meeting?
I've
been trying to find it, but I think I'm going to push some stuff there.
They were essentially talking about, for the most part, education as educational, like forums, that kind of stuff. And outreach, I think, was more related to like other local groups, people who we haven't really necessarily been in contact with. How do we get in contact with them? What can we help them with? What can they help us with? That's the gist of what they were talking about.
The goal of this conceptual conversation is to just figure out what that means for us.
What that means, possibly, and probably partly also how.
Got it.
Okay. Because
we determine what groups aren't well represented.
Yeah.
Is that a great topic?
Are we supposed to outreach to other occupied groups?
To other groups, not occupied. Well, like, some of us are outreaching to Occupy HUD to help with that, because they're, what I understand.
We've done a lot about other groups have been in
outside of the UC area.
for people to get involved with workgroups is they see how effective it is amongst relations.
Not to offend anyone, but we haven't really pulled
Well, let's face it, we've got to a place where we actually have a place to sit down inside, you know, and that still isn't, you know, it's not perfect. And, you know, there's a whole host, I mean, the list of the rest of the world is pretty big. Even the rest of the world locally is pretty big. And, you know, there needs, I describe it as there's those who are in the middle of the boiling pot, and then there's the people who would like to get in, who don't know where their place is, or how they fit in, or even where we are, how to find us, as much as that might seem preposterous to us. There are people who simply cannot accommodate for a variety of reasons, from not being able to find us to, you know, they need a calendar that's a couple weeks or, you know, in advance, and we're posting 24 hours or on Twitter feed. And I said it at a GA before the holidays, I said, this is not what democracy looks like, this is what the face of Twitter feed looks like. You know, I mean, come on. So there's a whole bunch of factors at play there. It's going to be a function of who shows up, what their connections are. I mean, I got involved with outreach. I'll be going to the natural basis of constituencies and groups and the context of my life and opening doors and unfolding that sort of stuff. So, what direction we outreach in is going to be a function of who really wants to. I've already opened the door and had a resolution on the Crusade for Voters, which is a 15-year-old black political voter action empowerment kick-ass, you know, alongside the NAACP, helped create the local chapter. The elder activist agency, and they passed a unanimous resolution finding common ground with Occupy. And sometime in January, the third or fourth week, when they have a meeting, they're hoping for some number of people to come from here and begin a conversation with them. Nobody's picked up on it. I understand it's how it is. But the invitation is open. You know, the resolution included both us and Occupy the Hood, and Occupy Wall Street is a larger one. So that door is already open. I'm feeling like that kind of, I said earlier, my life and my background and my connections. I feel the best thing for me to do is to open that door and then find the other door that I'm the only one to go. I don't need to be part of the greater conversation. And then I'm looking to maybe crack the code and find a permanent base that somehow gets put in the organization. Maybe it's possible. Yeah, I'm following inspiration. I've been turned down 10 times already as I've made the pitch. You know, but outreach is there's so many levels, and I think that the best way we can do it is to decide whether or not growing it, expanding it, networking it. I networking is really in bridge making and connecting. You know, there's so much you can do, but it's really going to be for the people who decide that is going to be a priority or a function. And I'm hoping that people, as opposed to hurry, scurry, and the theory of startup, I'm hoping that people who say that they're going to, are then able to. There have been some spectacular follow throughs and deliveries. Media did such amazing stuff. Other groups, you know, floundered and faltered, and you know, people wanted to and had to do, but everything was moving so fast. A lot of things
should have happened.
Because people
pushing into Facebook, or Facebook pushing it to us? Right now, Facebook is
being realistic and not.
But we're going to change that.
Over extending or over committing and then just no showing.
How's it going?
How are you?
Doing good.
So we have these going to
I just been wearing
what we could do since we are.
Yeah.
It's hard for one person to say, oh yeah, I want to outreach to this person, or to this group of people, but it's hard to just say, I want to do that by myself. So while we're actually in the group, want to just brainstorm and just make a physical list of every single place, every single organization that we actually know about, have knowledge about in the city of Richmond. No, it's a huge thing. Once you actually have a physical list and look at, okay, these are all the places that we can designate someone to call up to invite people from our organization to our meetings, invite people. But because when you have more people that want to get involved, then the actual things that need to get done become easier. You can delegate them. So you can delegate things. It's not more resting on one person because we're kind of spread thin on some things. But I think that's been the biggest issue this last year, finding what to do with such a small community. And so if you have a physical list, you can look at and say, okay, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
We can look up
all the numbers on this list, all the addresses on this list. We can call, we can send a letter, we can send whatever we want to, invite people to all of our events. This is our website, this is our this. We want to tabs on you,
tabs on us. Specifically for
and maybe work in that direction because all the other directions we've done into that.
And it is.
Well, this list right here is a little helpful.
And it's also a timeline of things we've done,
timeline of what's coming up. And
so the tunnel. When I say lunch, I'm talking about like very.
So that would be good to send to people.
Absolutely. Every day.
I like that. I have the liberty. It's on the ability to.
So if you want to copy that, okay, this is a little friendly note of my permission. We'd love to see your face.
This is still outreach.
Let's totally get the list.
And maybe if we can review, I mean, I know I meant to make copies of it.
I'd love to see outreach to the police, honestly, invite them in, give them love, and maybe they'll love us back. I know it sounds strange and crazy, but
you know what?
I love the idea of giving flowers.
That is so me. That is so me. I want to take that one out. One thing I want to say is that, yes, absolutely, we'll talk in
multiple
groups.
Okay. Work groups that can benefit.
I think
each
it's
going to
be essential
get information that information in one of the workers I'm in and be like, oh, this is relevant to this work group I'm also involved with. This
isn't a one-time thing. It will do. So make it really work. It's going to be. That's going to be our outreach project. So let's say you two guys teamed up to take on, let's say, the Unitarian Church, because they're a network, or the Episcopal Church. So there's groups that are interested and like-minded and totally have a base and resources and excuse the pun, pulpits, you know, the bully pulpit, where they can get media attention through professional associations, and if we can, like with the Crusade, if we can start nurturing ongoing, so that you begin to attend their things and get to know the people and be presenting on a regular basis into whatever their monthly schedule is. This is what's happening with Occupy. We'd like to have some, you know, sometimes it's resolutions of support that get released in press conferences, but it's really a developing and ongoing relationship. It's not a stop and drop, here's the list of what's going on for the next 2 weeks, will you guys come out and support us? The best way to do this is to grow a relationship with those entities that you're taking on. That's what the Crusade is looking for. We got a resolution out of them, and they're inviting two or three, up to a half a dozen people from the two local occupiers to come and begin starting conversations on the common ground and strategies and ways that, you know, the common agenda can move forward. And that's really what I think is, it's there's another aspect to outreach, which is just like PR canvassing, petitions, you know, flyering for events in neighborhoods, and that's a different thing. The kind of growing of networks and mutual support and common agendas is more than a stop and drop of flyers or getting them, you know, weekly electronic communication for, you know, what our events are. It's finding out what are the concerns that they have that, even if it's you bringing back, this is something the municipals or the police union. I love having conversations with them about the fact that they're seeing the mayor in the city for unpaid overtime. And I've had so many conversations with some of the guys that took us away when they arrested us.
Yeah, I did too.
Yeah.
I apologized that he wasn't getting paid the good
time. Oh, I know.
Sorry for that.
So I think realizing the assignment is important from the beginning. I mean, again, I can't tell anybody how to do it. I mean, I can tell you conceptually what I've seen was, and I don't know what. Did I hear you say in your introduction that you're involved in organizing? So what I described in terms of making connection with other groups is in, rather than dropping information, but building a relationship that's an exchange. Does that seem to be a sound strategy to you?
Well, I guess I had two questions for the group to consider before we think about which groups to reach out to. One is, who are the target groups that we want here? Not just groups because of organizations, but the people who are listening in the room.
Uh-huh.
So for example, just from this my first meeting, from a historical perspective,
I'm interested in helping facilitate.
When everybody was in the room, this group was 2 days ago.
One thing
six,
I wanted to,
at least as far as I could tell, six people of color in the room. So I would just name that as a dynamic to shift
workers,
given multiple people's name, the system in this room. So if you understand that system,
We're talking rank and file.
And that's true. It's true that it's cool that cops
are. If you're the color person, then you're responsible to check out an email.
Have a long history of being brutalized and crushed by the cops. So I don't just name that as a dynamic. So I'll cite that as a concern. But cops aside, I think that the second question I would have for the group is, where do we have relationships already? Right? So there's a question of relationship building that's really important. Right? It might be good to start by saying, where did you have relationships with
random people?
So maybe, I mean, Todd was feeling this. Also, I think the question was, what's great? So, like, let's come up with that community tomorrow. That's great. Then we can start by saying, facilitation group. And if that is being a short list, then we have the next to our half who we want to reach out to. We know the general session based on our fight.
Sunday. And I'm trying to get one person from each
of the list. I can name all the organizations that have, or unions, or individuals. The IWW has already sent us letters of solidarity, SEIU, SONG, the Defenders, the Peace Education Center, the ACLU. We've been in contact with the NAACP. And we've been in contact with
they were at 5 o'clock
Virginia
organizers. Okay, we've been in contact with them.
We went out meeting before and
I've been in contact with the Virginia Libertarian Party.
Then
they're ready to go.
So
ready to be edited.
On the state level, we'll only participate if there's a camera to keep them. And when I say camera, not just us taping each other, I'm talking about
Channel 6, Channel 12, National News, people eat it all up.
Get this to the website, send me a message.
Or participate.
Send me a message.
It's an email maybe. And then I think your best bet
on your screen is actually
have two.
There's no
reason somebody in
communication.
Can write the local chapter, probably the most active one.
Where it's like, this is the group that worked on it, and here's like the...
In the city, I've been talking to them. Again, it's a very slow process, but it is slow, slowly opening up. And in the conversation that I had, you can confirm, you know, the validity of what I've been told is that neither Saline nor the Richmond local is ever going to turn people out into the streets for this or for that. Press conferences, confrontation, and that's Saline and the state. And then the local is very laid-back, elderly, and somewhat conservative. They're not going to be on the front edge of anything, so it's important to have the conversation.
Yeah, I think talking to the local leaders is probably a better bet, because you might not do it in the name of NAACP, but they might want to learn how they can plug in on their own. A lot of them are old activists, like the old guard, and maybe they still want to figure out how they can plug in. I don't know if you get the NAACP as NAACP, but you can always pay some of those people who still have...
They are very close to... And getting involved, and that's been mine.
And that's establishing an ongoing relationship with the entity and the members of it.
The true thing.
Beginning
One of the reasons is that we have kept...
That's going to take time and energy, and I've kind of, by default,
that's not the biggest responsibility to do.
Because I first spotted the acting on the news like it got posted. So the NAACP is definitely... something that needs somebody to tend to it. I'm going to keep picking and poking at that in whatever fashion, just because I know some of these people have, you know, 23 years of, you know, zigzagging across each other's paths and combining this issue and that. So that's one thing that I'll definitely...
Yeah. So,
I was going to say three things. Two others are the coalition project and the Alliance of Workers Advisors. One thing I was just going to say is, as far as getting alliances built, the Virginia business from 14 is going to be really great outreach.
And then also there's important announcements that come out of Virginia as well.
We'll be all the ones that are always at one time and have a chance to engage in conversation with individuals or organizations. So that's something I'm not really concerned about so much, because I know we'll be there, we'll be working together, and we'll have all these great ideas out of this amazing
through this event,
couple of hours, we'll get to talk and really get organized.
I mean, I do think that every pitch has a point person in terms of coalition contracts.
Alliance
I don't care about. I put my email address.
So
the name,
groups
website,
that I have not heard mentioned yet is the
I'm just
leftist church.
Email,
you know, and that I'm not talking about the conservatives. I'm not talking about the fundamentalists or the right wing. I'm talking about, you know, Episcopals and Quakers and Unitarians and Unity, the left leaning words.
Yeah, and you need to.
I don't know what the current language is for the church. The activist church crowd. The left leaning activist church crowd. I know these folks.
We're kind of responsible for like,
you know, and that includes the Baptist Ministers Association.
Go talk to this person.
Well, if we're going into religions, I'd love to see a way of bringing in some of the...
Mic check! 5 minutes.
Two families of friends that I love to death that have been begging to come. But, you know, it is what it is. Is there a way to get
the Islamic?
Yeah, and for
supports like they are under such scrutiny, and for the least non-justification, for simply being breathing in the wrong space at the wrong moment.
I mean,
from great inconvenience to
we're thrilled.
And there's a very warranted and justifiable reluctance that I think there's so many other areas that I don't even realize are important in these days to talk to people. And let them know and accept their support from however they choose to. But I don't see that as a priority for outreach either. You know, the Muslim community would have to step on the day by one communicating.
But these are the people being oppressed that are here to help.
Yeah.
Or at least that's one of the reasons I'm
here.
I'm sorry,
I know
we're like running up short of time. I was going to say a few things quick.
So let me just wrap up. It's cool to have the timeline of things and that up. I think that when you outreach to people, it's good to be clear about what you're asking them to do. So coming to these meetings is good, but most people are not going to sign up to come to process meetings. People are going to come to stuff that's exciting, right? So for all the folks that held apart for that for so long, that was an ongoing action for people who were down to show up for that because it was exciting and hot. This is less likely to draw people in, so it'd be useful to sort of even go through the, maybe it's on there already, I'm sorry, but it'd be cool to go through the timeline and be like, we're doing this thing on this day, will you come, right?
Community events.
What an action, right? If I have a minute later, I'm going to ask everybody here to come to a big action we're doing on Tuesday next week, right? It's an action that's meant to antagonize the right wing in the legislature that's trying to destroy the lives of people all over the state, right? So that's a concrete thing. People, so you were naming relationship building an important outreach tool, so is having a clear ask of people. And generally, sort of just showing up to meetings is less helpful, so we should figure out what those things are in that timeline. The second thing is, I think maybe people have had this conversation earlier, but when we're naming organizations, it's also helpful to be clear, are we asking, what's the utility of asking organizations rather than trying to reach individuals directly?
Everybody?
Do we want...
Everybody, I'm sorry to interrupt. There is a cameraman outside the window filming us at the moment. It's Channel 6. Y'all don't... If you do not want your face on the news at all, just do not...
I already told them this is close.
So you just...
I don't have to look at it. Well, I'm just saying,
huh? We can all have funny hats and sell one right behind me.
It is a closed meeting.
We don't want to.
No,
it's really hard. Thank you.
I don't want to get there.
Just because we told them that we're
going to do it. No, they can stay outside.
Yeah.
That's the important thing.
They can act
on
it.
Nice
and cold
outside.
You
won't be out there.
So I was just saying on the organization
I'd probably
thing,
go say hi to them.
Some organizations actually don't have members, right? Where they, there's a lot of people who know about the organization, but they're not going to turn out. I think actually the NAACP's for the past 20 years been an organization that's not likely to turn people out in large numbers. So I'll just name it. I think then the last thing is that, so my Virginia majority, we have a local Richmond chapter. I connect whoever it is with our local chapter, who then has relationships to many folks all over the city and some of the suburbs. And we're part of what's called the 501c3 state table, which is groups with relatively big capacity to turn out, which we're going to be doing over the next couple of weeks from the GA.
Well, anything we say will be off the record.
But you know, I think a lot of the groups around the table are ones that, at least in some way, shape, or form, want to be able to figure out how to plug people from Occupy into the existing movements and things that are already happening, so that there's actually events or things for people to actually show up and participate in.
Yeah, we're actually chairing the table, so I came with a list of those things tonight. So
awesome.
Yeah.
What is the thought process there, generally?
So I think the whole list of groups that are involved in that is probably a good place to start. As far as group outreach.
Yeah, I guess meetings.
I'm more interested in getting, just personally, I'm more interested in getting individuals here from those groups. I think that's more valuable, if not, than just having, you know, the endorsement from a certain group.
Oh, yeah.
Because
yeah.
they're just, because people that come are going to bring more people. And that may, in a longer stretch, bring the endorsement of the groups, the other groups that they are with.
Yeah.
I'm sorry,
interject for a moment here. I understand that there was some, like, that the Tea Party reached out to Occupy Richmond.
A member of the Tea Party reached out to us and talked about getting a small meeting. And then we had a small meeting. But what happened? They chatted, and then the media said that we were teaming up, and then we said that we weren't.
So the real thing that happened there is that there was one individual who wanted to have that meeting very bad, and then and made sure that the meeting was there.
But there was nothing, like, nobody said, hey, we have this in common.
Because it was just individuals from both groups. No, actually, I wasn't there, so I probably should speak.
I was there.
Okay.
Basically, I was actually the person that this person contacted to have that meeting. What is your question? I'm sorry.
What happened? What was the discussion there?
It's online. So you can watch the whole thing.
For me,
what happened was we just sat down and talked about things that we agreed on, which were
workers make their own beds.
Occupy
then Facebook official mission page can just share
the conversation
yeah.
like 2 hours.
So easy.
Yeah.
We didn't make any decisions. We made sure that there were no decisions that were going to be made. It was just a conversation. Like he said, the unfortunate part of it was that there was a reporter there, which literally we walked out the door, our pictures were on Reddit.com. The next day we woke up and the article was that was sort of a little bit of a surprise.
So the media attention thwarted the goals of the
meeting.
Well, I don't really think that.
I think it's sort of a couple of different approaches, actually. Because the media prior to that was rounding up and churning up the narrative.
All the
that was getting picked up by Bill O'Reilly and under that. We were looking at having a national spotlight on us, so to speak. Us versus the people. And that media basically killed it. That was the end of that.
So there's not going to be any future communication between the Tea Party people and Occupy people?
I think that the future communication will be with individuals, not with the essential groups. For instance, there's a forum so will other organizations.
Not
just related to Tea Party at all. But there's a lot of support. So that's what the focus was, just figuring out where we
fit. So requests that I've seen come in from other entities.
Yeah, it was not anything like we're joining up. For instance, the article says, can Occupy and the Tea Party team up?
Because it's done in a very, like,
that's the headline.
Scattershot manner. It's just like, oh, go put this
which
event. Well,
the
what is
that?
Soon we know it.
Just have to control the salon.
Sounds great, but people
so
don't show
that's
up.
That's why we also
look at our media meeting. We don't have a
goals,
location.
Like, that's what the media is going to do, right?
That's
kind of how we are out of our control.
With
less discussion about
communications, it's going
to
be an hour and a half before GA, one person for each work group, and that's why communications.
in communications, we try and work with these working groups. And,
let's say 30. A list of names is not very helpful unless like, we have a strategy. Like, what are we going to do with a list of names?
Well, let's get them to have a list of names and then have a strategy.
You know, or,
just
know,
say, here are people that we can
contact. I want to get this stuff now, but
press
releases are very, or like,
well, people have already contacted us.
For instance,
Jeff and
Robotics
workshop training.
You
know, he's been asking for this since December, and we have yet to find a date to do it. I mean, there's plenty of things to do with the contacts that we have already. We just have to call them. For instance, on this list right here, it's call Tony Cosby, call Miriam McCormick, call Jeff Winter, call Andrew Sharp. There's already a list of people that we can go ahead and call the next week and figure out where we can work together.
I guess about a minute before I wrap it up, I'll take a meeting on the downstairs.
What I would, if we're, because I think you've got a great point, is we need something to present to come back from this.
No, there was one thing, we need,
so let's present a list of things that Bentley's got, that Risha, you've got, and some people that you've been talking about. You are somebody, you are a member here. Is your name again, Dan? Dana is here with the group. And personally, I think the single best thing we can do presenting from this little group is give some time for Ricky to talk, is give some time for Dana to talk, is perhaps give some time for Bentley to talk because they've been in contact with people and planning some events. And let's actually hear what you guys think is the important strategy for 2012 for your organizations that we can then perhaps weave into the strategy we're developing for this that's what I'm more like as a way of returning
to this. I think that's more the point of outreach is when we hear you or when you come, when we contact you. Really what I think Occupy is.
Mic check!
Mic check!
Mic check!
Time! Time!
Good timing.
You know, I hate to.
We just need to go through
that. We have a solid
consciousness
if we do it, we have to be just like absolutely insane.
From the kitchen.
It'd be better if we get the price of this food. Yeah, and I don't need it. I don't want to pause.
Take it down to the kitchen.
Mic check!
We're going to take a few minutes for a break before we come back in.
Snack time.
Food has been prepared and is downstairs.
I'll come.
And some digits solved it.
Okay. Since I forgot to clarify this before we started, did every affinity group have a scribe of some kind? Or was someone writing notes?
Yes. I reached in.
Okay, awesome. Thank you. I guess we'll just start at the top of the list. Would communication like to brief everybody on what happened?
Hello.
Hello.
So we talked about a bunch of stuff, some problems, and some solutions that are already in the works, and that we're hoping that will be done. Sending information out in a timely manner for any event. Media email gets checked every day. Media needs people who are accountable to keep up with that. Also, they really need the who, what, why, where, and when. That is crucial if they want to put the information out and they don't want to put out partial information. So that is one thing that is being worked on. And as part of that communication is they're going to be utilizing the website much more than Facebook, and then linking to the Facebook from the website. There is a problem with check emails from work groups. Each work group needs a functional email. It also needs to have at least two people who are keeping each other accountable for checking that. People who are not online, the AccuPhone needs to be updated much more. We will be working on that. There is going to be a new website in the style of the New York City's General Assembly .net, NYCGA.net. It will give work groups their own space to put up minutes from their individual meetings and to see what's going on, and it will also give a space to individuals to voice their opinions or ideas. And that should be available in about a month where that media is open. Also, the highlighting of each GA's minutes in a and not just a long form of the minutes, but have the facilitation group who worked on the GA that night work with the scribe to do points of consensus, important announcements, and have followed through with information from the contact person for each of those individual actions. Debrief, and that is utilized, debriefing for every work group meeting, and the text trees being utilized. Also, we just discussed that when people are working with multiple work groups, you don't necessarily have to be heavily in each work group, but it helps for information to get traveled around more. And then that's more internal communication. The breakout groups that we all just participated in seem to be working really well. We like those things. Getting involved in work groups gets you into that circle, and it helps you feel that your new people especially, helps you feel that your voices are being heard, and you can better arrange thoughts in small groups. And then posting work group events has been adding numbers. We had a lot of new faces tonight. That's excellent. That's happened last week at the meeting as well. Getting more information out during the GA process as far as internal communication, as opposed to clogging up things with proposals and decision making, have it more dialogue style soapbox. And that's it. Questions?
I think we went into pulling clarification on the hockey phone for the new people.
Okay. I don't even. We have an hockey phone.
I have a phone.
You have a phone number?
804-396-4997.
What's that number again?
804. 396-4997. That is more than 99%.
396-4-99%.
So 7 is being on those generic more.
4997? Yeah, 4997. And where is that?
Is there multiple ones?
Very briefly, the AccuPhone is something that we run through Google Voice, which is a service offered by Google, where like you can call in a particular number and it can either ring multiple cell phones, but we have it set up to where it just goes directly to a voicemail, and we're just using the voicemail as a way to like record a new message every time, you know, every couple of days about new worker meetings that are happening, and more particularly about GAs and GA endorsed events. And at the end, it has like a little alert like, hey, you can sign up for action alerts at X number. And then you can also like text in a question or leave a voicemail if you have questions for Occupy Richmond. And the people that run the Occuphone hotline like check those and try to respond to them at somewhat of a time. And we have like four people working on it now. If anyone wants to help,
okay. I just had a request for outreach to go next. The bylaw procedure here. Anyone have a problem with that? Okay, so.
So basically, just define what outreach was and what groups we should contact and what that should be. Decided that outreach was basically just trying to spread the message and get some mutual assistance going on, like grow, expand, and network what we're doing. And trying to find people who are part of groups more than groups themselves sometimes. Like the NAACP has a lot of hoops that they have to jump through. So we'd want to contact members of groups instead of actual groups a lot. And some groups we can contact, and they will help us. But we have contacted a lot of groups and they've responded and we've been communicating, but we need to get more one-on-one communication with them going and have it be like a regular thing that we have people set and doing and keep it going. Some of that's been kind of tapering off. That's mostly it. We need to get groups set coming to events instead of PAs more, because people don't really like coming to these if they're not a part of the group. But if we get them to come to events, they'll be excited and have fun things going and have them actually participate. Anything up to point us?
I think we were also going to take the opportunity to let the two people speak.
I'm Dana, and I'm not here representing the group that I work for, but I'm organized as an organization, but we're part of many other groups, which I think Rishi will speak a little bit more about, in terms of those groups that are working on issues that folks in Occupy can plug into, and a lot of the actions that they can plug into, and hopefully you all, I work in the General Assembly pretty much every year for the last 5-6 years. How you can play into not only those events at the General Assembly that are going on with progressive organizations, but also other events that are happening outside the General Assembly, because there are also those things. Rishi's going to talk about an event that's happening next week, but there are a lot of issues. I particularly work on poverty-based issues. And wherever you all feel comfortable plugging into those issues, whether it's at the General Assembly, this particular session, or in any of the events that we have throughout the year, I hope that you'll feel empowered to participate and get really activated on issues, as well as, you know, a lot of things that are happening. Obviously, this is going to be an election year, and there's going to be a lot of political things happening, but a lot of the way that things actually change is getting issue-oriented and working on issues. And I work specifically on predatory lending, which I think affects a lot of people, not only in the low-income community, but also the middle-income community. And not just that, but banking issues, the inequality in the banking system, and how we, well, personally, it's not really my job, but personally, I feel like we just get raked over the coals pretty much on all levels in terms of finances. Hopefully you'll be inspired to work on economic justice, which I think is part of what we're here for, but on the multiple levels in which we are taken advantage of and which our money is used against us again and again. So that's my financial security.
Can you talk just a little bit about predatory lending? Because as you said, that was something that was really important to you, and I think part of what we're really doing in this time is trying to figure out what's really important to our community members and
sure.
What are things we might work on this week.
So I work on predatory lending are loans which usually the interest rate is extremely high. The terms involved usually are pretty harsh, and people, almost 99% of people who take out those loans end up failing in the end to actually pay them back, because they're designed that way. And it's not that, you know, they took out a loan that they, you know, should have known they could never have paid back. Most of the time, most people have every intention of paying them back, and they try. It's just that most of the time, they're designed for you to fail. And so that would include payday loans, car title loans, line of credit loans by former payday lenders because they don't want to follow the law. That would be, banks are now offering payday loans if you're Wells Fargo or Bank of America, or there's a couple of other banks that are offering their own version of a payday loan, and that gets around all restrictions that we've already put in place. There are refund anticipation loans, which hopefully are going to be gone after this year, but we still have a lot of those around. And all of these are different ways, including other things like rent-to-own and other kinds of predatory products that usually end up costing a rent. Like a predatory payday loan, for example, is the average is 300% interest. So, and that is what our legislature thinks is completely acceptable.
Delegate McClellan actually pass some really good paid legislation 2 years ago?
No. She was one of many legislators who helped. Mm-hmm. I think it was Delegate Glenn Oder from Newport News who was the patron of the bill.
Okay.
Delegate McClellan has been very supportive of anti-predatory lending efforts. So she's a delegate from the Richmond area. She represents a small portion of Churchill and the fans. And so she's been very supportive. Almost every Richmond state legislator, I can't think of any of them that have not been supportive of sort of capping or limiting predatory loans. There are legislators in other parts of the state that feel like it's a free market and we should allow people, if they make a bad decision, to suffer the consequences. But honestly, why we even have 300% loans is kind of beyond me, even at this point. And I've been working on this for 4 years. So,
is there anybody in state who is doing alternatives to payday loan programming?
There are a lot, actually. Credit unions, many credit unions around the state have started to offer those kinds of what we call alternative loans, although many credit unions don't even want to be associated with the name payday loans. They don't even want to call it an alternative loan.
Right.
But many of them do offer small dollar loans that are much cheaper than a payday loan. A payday loan is short-term, small dollar. But there's no reason it needs to be a short-term loan. That's what causes the interest rate to be very high and for it harder to pay back. Because you have to pay the whole thing back on your next payday or two paydays after that. Which most loans, you get some sort of broken up into payments. So that's usually the problem. So most credit unions offer some sort of small dollar loan that you can pay back over 3 to 6 months.
Is there an established activist network or movement specifically focusing on the payday loan issues?
Yes, there's the Virginia Partnership to Encourage Responsible Lending. It's a loose coalition of lots of different groups that specifically work on predatory lending in particular.
If Occupy were interested in trying to create community-based alternatives to payday loans with financial mentoring, financial literacy, no interest, I mean, I know some pilot programs in other parts of the country, you know, would there be partners or other established groups that you would think would almost guaranteed be interested in coalescing around such a move?